Sorry, I'm a little late for trainer talk. I'm just getting back from the hotel with Evie. So I'll start with her. So she and Emma are both very nervous little girls. They seem to be afraid of the world right now. So we're trying to get them over that. And Evie is, she gets a little better each day. So I took her to the hotel, and she didn't have any meltdowns, which was very nice. The last time I took Emma to the hotel, we didn't get 4 feet past the door. So I was very happy with Evie. We went in two elevators. We did a couple of very short sets of stairs. We walked a lot, just changing directions, trying to get her to focus on me. And she did pretty well. So she is still in the service dog training program. We have not decided if we're going to breed her or not, so we're still considering that. Chloe got spayed today. I guess she just came in. I saw Donna's car. So, poor thing. She was very excited to go out with Donna. She was like, yay! And I was like, you're in for a rude awakening, kid. What else? I took Proxy to CVS to pick up a couple prescriptions for Carlene. And we were there for like over 45 minutes because we were waiting. It should have been ready, but it was not. I don't know if you can hear it, but everybody is howling from the top, so I'm sure the barn dogs are going to start in a second. What else? Oh yeah, so we just wandered this tiny CVS for 45 minutes until it was done. Proxy was like looking at me like, can we go now? And I was looking at him like, I wish we could go now. Where else did I go today? The days blend together, so I never remember if I went there today or... where did I go to? I took Percy to a place. I took Percy to Walmart. There we go. He's still really nervous, so he's constantly looking around him to see if anyone is around who doesn't want to be surprised by someone. There was someone who was pushing a cart that was a little bit squeaky, and he was just like looking and listening for this cart for a while, and it wasn't even in eyesight. I'm just constantly like telling him like, leave it, and you don't want to coddle him and support the behavior, but I mean, you also, it's a fine line, so you want to, like, make sure he knows you're there, obviously, but you also can't be like, it's okay, because that just intensifies poor behaviors, so he needs a little bit more work. My star of this week. Rambo is very good. I think he might be one of the next to be matched. He's just a really good boy. All of Sizzle's pups I'm just so in love with. They all have their own perfect personalities. They're just awesome. I'm a little bit partial now. Yesterday, John, Lynn, and I worked on some, I wouldn't call it dog aggression, but we used Lynn's dog, Colton, as what we call a bait dog. So, Sandy, who else? Sloan, Fred, and Proxy, we worked with Colton. And most of the time, like, the dogs didn't even have an issue, and the only dogs we had a slight issue with was, oh, and Moira, was when we worked Sandy with Moira, neither of them cared about Colton. Moira was pretty frightened of Sandy because Sandy has a big bark. But by the end of that session, we... Stacy had come, and we put Lacey into the mix because she's a wild child. So by the end of that, we had four dogs. We were all in a line together, and we walked to the barn, turned around, and walked back towards the T10, and they all just walked beautifully together, so that was very good. We'll probably need to keep using Colton. I would love to get Wanda here because she's a yappy dog, and that kind of sets off some dogs. What else? The exterminator guy was here to set more rat traps. I really hope that some point soon we can get a handle of the rat problem. I love domestic rats. I own three. I do not love wild barn rats. I had one run over my foot a couple weeks ago, and I did not like it. So hopefully this guy can help us out soon. At least lower the rat population. We survived the snowstorm, so I slipped over Friday night of last week because I had to work at 7 on Saturday, and everyone was expecting like it to be like so snowy at that point, and I looked outside when I woke up at the guest house, and there was like an inch of snow on the ground. It was snowing. It was a little more than flurrying. I was like, I could have driven here. I could have slept at my own house. And then after my shift, my mom had told me that I should expect to spend both nights, both Friday and Saturday night here. And I just was like, I want to sleep in my own bed. So I made a break for it. Made it home safely. Love having a car that has four-wheel drive. Capri got to go home, and her family helped shovel all the kennels out, which is just huge for us because on the snow days we're short-staffed as it is, and it's just a lot of weight taken off our backs, so it was just so nice. And then Capri's family also took little Mandy, so it's, while I would love to have gotten to know her a lot better, it's easier having 8 puppies. Now we have 4 Merles and 4 Mantles, and it's so easy to count them. What else? The puppies are on gruel and baby food, and they're starting to learn their names already. Some of them are starting to learn how to sit patiently for their spoon feeding. Of this age, like 4 to 6 weeks is probably my favorite age of pups, and then adults. In between that, they're just crazy and kooky. I adore them, but my preferred age is little babies or adults. I'm gonna check Explore. We had a trainer meeting the other night, and we talked about how some of these dogs would benefit from being fed in their kennels so that we can get a better handle on some of the barking. So I'm sure you've noticed that we've been feeding fewer dogs out here. We're still going to do feeding outside. It's just we're going to split who gets fed in there. We have a couple high schoolers that came to help today and yesterday. They're going to be doing community service or something here. When a dog gets their vest on, how does their demeanor change? So for most of them, especially the adults, they go from like goofy, let me lick your face, I'm so happy, tail wagging, to like serious, like you put their vest on, you clip it, and then you like put your hand on them and they're just like, okay, I'm ready to work. I'm not going to try to lick your face. I'm not going to lean on you. So that's what we look for. I talked to Sharon, who's Capri's mom, the other day. I think it was just the day after they took them home. And she was saying like how much her kids are enjoying puppy sitting, and that Capri was so happy to be home, and I don't blame her. It's hard for the owners to be away from their dog, but it's even harder for the dogs to be away from their owners. But, alright, I'm gonna go help Diane get the rest of the food ready, so I hope you guys have a good night.